Hi everyone, and welcome to the next lesson in Django Fundamentals. Okay, so I did make a mistake in the previous video, which I noticed, which was pretty bad. So I do apologize for that. So I decided to just re-record that video because, yeah, there were too many mistakes and I couldn't just edit it out. Okay, so let's go ahead and do this again. So apologies again. So we're going to go ahead and utilize Django messages. Now, these messages are like user events, okay, so notifications that we want to be that we want passed once a user has completed an action. For example, if a user is registered. So first thing is first, let's go to our app, to views.py, and we need to import Django messages first of all. So I'm just going to put here in a comment, import Django messages, and I'm just going to put here in parentheses notifications. Okay. So to do that, we need to say from Django.contrib. Import messages. Okay, so now we can utilize Django messages. Now let's test it on a view. So I'm going to test it on the register view. So under form.save, we want to go ahead and pass our message. So in this case, I'm going to say messages.success. And this will take two parameters. The first one will just be a normal request. And then in text, I'm going to say user registration was successful. Okay. Right, and this message is going to be shown on the My Login page. Okay, so it's going to be shown on this page. So whenever we put our Django message here, the page that we redirect to, okay, will be the page on which we want to see our message. Okay, so that should make sense. Next, we want to go to our actual My Login page, because once our user has been registered, he's going to redirect to the login page. And here is where we want to see that small notification message. So if we scroll down, we want to go ahead and just, you know, make sort of like a space here in between our button and register in this case. So we want to have some space here between the button and this text here, don't have an account, for our message to be just here. Okay. So here in between, I'm just going to go ahead and type in the following. So I'm just going to say for message in messages. Okay, so you're going to add a for loop and we need to end this for, and we are going to go just a little bit further and we need to actually check if our message.level is equal to default underscore. And it would be message underscore levels, and then it will be dot success. And then we just add our percentage symbol, closing the tag. Okay, and then we need to just end if here. And if, and we could nest a bit. Then we want to go ahead and actually render our message, like so. Okay, now this message here that we're rendering will be this here. Okay, so we're rendering out this text here, user registration was successful, just on the login page, because this is where we want our users to be redirected to. Okay, just like this. Okay. Right, perfect. So what we want to do now is actually go ahead and test this and see how it looks. So let's go and do just that. Let's register a user. So here I'm just going to say user1 at gmail.com, add the password, set it here, just register. And there we go, we have a text message that says user registration was successful. Okay, now there are two issues here. This doesn't look very nice, and we actually need to add just a break space here, just there. Okay. And we can remove this one here. Okay, so the message doesn't go away, it doesn't look nice at all. So let's edit these two problems. The first issue we want to address is the fact that we want to make this look a little bit better, first of all. So first thing we can do is we can actually utilize a paragraph tag here, which I'm going to do. And within this paragraph tag, I'm going to set some properties. Now, the first thing I want to do is add a class. Okay, so I'm going to use some Bootstrap and I'm going to say here alert primary. Okay, and then I'm just going to go ahead and say float center, text center, just like that. Okay, now what this is going to do is going to change the color of our message here. Okay, so if you haven't seen the other videos in this series, you need to make sure that you have this Bootstrap sort of you have Bootstrap or Bootswatch in my case here in your code for to utilize these attributes here. Okay, so I just want to make that clear. Okay, so let's see now how this looks. Okay, another thing I want to do actually is just change the color of my message here. So to do that, we would need to go to our static file, styles.css. Just make sure that you have you're connected to your CSS file here. Now I'm going to go to styles.css and say .messageText. And I'm going to set the color to white. Okay, now I can go back to my login. And here in the paragraph tag, I'm going to say messageText. Okay, so this will make sure that our message here, which is going to be user registration was successful, will be white. And surrounding that, we're going to have this Bootstrap property that will show up in yellow, but we want to make this green. So green would be success. Now let's go ahead and try this again. Register a user, user2@gmail.com, put in the password. Okay, and register. Okay, now this is looking a lot better. So now it says user registration was successful. Now the last issue we want to solve is the fact that this notification isn't disappearing. It's not going anywhere. It's still staying there. And this isn't so great. Okay, we can also see we have an issue there with our line. So we might need to add just a tag there to add some space. So let's go and solve the last issue. Now the last thing that we need to do is use some JavaScript here. So I'll close everything here and let's go to JS. Now make sure that you have JavaScript here. So make sure you've linked a JavaScript file here and that you have jQuery. Okay, very important to have that. Okay, I do have videos where I've explained how to connect a JavaScript and a CSS file to Django. So just be sure to check that out if you are a bit lost. So let's go to JavaScript and we're going to create a simple JavaScript, you could say, JavaScript script. So here I'm going to say message timeout, so just a normal variable, and I'm going to set it to document.getElementById that says message timer. Okay, just like that. Okay, great. Now we need to actually create a function. So I'm going to say set timeout, open the function here with parentheses. Move this one down and we can go ahead and in our curly braces, we can go ahead and say message timeout.style.display and we're gonna say this is none. Okay, perfect. So we have everything set here and ready to go. So our message style is going to be seen as none. And what we need to do is we need to set a time here. So I'm just gonna put 5,000 roughly. And that will do it. Okay, so what's going to happen? We're going to get a variable and we're going to link this by the element ID, which is message timer. So if we go to my login and we look for, if I can find it, our class here, we need to just add message equals message timer, just like that. So just be sure that you add that there so that we reference it. And what's going to happen, it's going to perform run a function on this paragraph tag here and its contents. So once the timer has been reached, it's going to display none and hide this notification. So this is a way that we can hide a Django flash message or user notification after a few seconds. Okay, so that's how we would go about doing this. Right, so let's go ahead and actually test this out now. So it should all be working. So let's register a user. Now user 3, hopefully 3 times the charm. So let's go ahead and do that. Get our password. Register. And then it says user registration was successful. And there we go, it disappears. Okay, so that's how we can go ahead and create user notifications in Django and modify it a little bit with some Bootstrap CSS, a bit of JavaScript to make a really nice notification appear for our users. Okay, so that's it.